I can't remember how long my unexpected lapse into slumber lasted, and cannot prove the events that came next were not purely delusional. You may believe it was all a dream to the moment when I rushed out of the house, stumbled to the shed where I had seen the old fort, and seized the ancient vehicle for a mad race over the haunted hills, arriving at last in the village of Townshend. When my frantic story sent a police unit out to the farmhouse, Akeley was gone without trace. The dogs and livestock were indeed missing, and there were some curious bullet holes in the exterior of the house, and some walls within. There were no metal canisters or machines, no laptop, no odor or vibrations, no footprints in the road, and none of the terrible objects I glimpsed in the very end. I stayed a week in Brattleboro after my escape, inquiring among people of every kind who had known Akeley. The results convinced me that in the matter is no mere figment of my imagination. Akeley's purchase of dogs, ammunition, and chemicals, even the cutting of his telephone wires, are all matters of record. The Akeley house was now avoided by everyone but the post deliverer and a few brave adventurers. I learned that Round Hill was notoriously haunted, but I could find no one who had closely explored it. Occasional disappearances of natives to the region were well attested, including Walter Brown, since the day I last saw him driving off. When I left Brattleboro, I resolved never to go back to Vermont, for I know that loathsome outside influences must be lurking there in the half-unknown hills, and that those influences have spies and emissaries in our world. To keep as far from them as possible is all that I ask of life in the future. Despite my efforts to forget it all and regain mental stability, certain questions continue relentlessly to plague my subconscious mind. Was it really your father who wrote that final email, begging me rescue him? Was there ever a chance of saving his life? In light of everything else, my own escape still unsettles me. Why, in their incomprehensible alien genius, did they allow me to survive my visit to the farm uncaptured? Yet the fear of which I can never rid myself is of the things I watched Akeley tell me about the planet Yoggoth, of the artificial progress which the Migo might lead our scientists to find that extraterrestrial hell. That researchers of Caltech, your own university, have now theorized the existence of a ninth planet in our own solar system should be a grave warning to you. I do not believe this planet to be the Yoggoth of which I learned through horrible whispers. Current calculations propose it to be of gaseous composition. Yet its presence proves there may still be unknown celestial bodies in our galaxy. I now pay special attention to advances in the field of astronomy, however small they fill my lungs with dread each time. But I still have to tell the ending of that terrible night in the farmhouse. As I said, I finally dropped into a troubled doze, filled with terrible dreams of monstrous landscapes. I awoke to noises in the hall outside my door. Thankfully, the noises quickly ceased and footsteps went away. I could swear I also heard quiet, receding laughter. Later, I heard voices from the study below. There seemed to be several speakers engaged in argument. Brought it on myself. Sent the message and the stone. Seeing and hearing. Damn you. Impersonal enforcer after all. Fresh shiny cylinder. Good God. Time we stopped small and human brain saying. Harmless. Peace. Couple of weeks. Theatrical. Well, alone for now. Okay. Something in the fragmentary discourse chilled me immeasurably. Raised the most grotesque and horrible doubts. Made me wish I might wake up and prove it all a dream. I must talk to Akeley at once, I thought, and convince him to leave with me. They had brainwashed him with their promises of cosmic revelations, but now he must listen to reason. We would escape before it was too late. Ah je, was ist das denn jetzt schon wieder? I half tiptoed from my room, gripping my pocket flashlight in my right hand. I dared not disturb the door to Akeley's bedroom, assuming he'd remained downstairs and that something else might lurk within. I wish to heaven I had quietly left the place before allowing the light to fall on the vacant chair in Akeley's study. Ach so, geht da runter, ne? Ja. resting on the chair, I saw three objects which the investigators did not find when they came later on. I hope devoutly that they were the waxen products of a master artist, despite what my innermost fears tell me. Welche Tür muss ich denn dann nehmen, wenn ich da nicht hinkomme? Wo ging das da raus? Wo soll ich denn jetzt hin? Da ist doch ein Durchgang, oder nicht? Verstehe ich nicht. Ich gehe einfach mal alle Wände entlang. Irgendwo werde ich dann ja wahrscheinlich schon irgendwas auslösen. Hoffentlich. Ah, great God, that whisperer in darkness with its morbid odor and vibrations. For the things in the chair. Ah, da sind wir. Ist das hier jetzt Wand? Was ist das hier unten? Perfect to the last. Subtle detail of microscopic resemblance or identity. Okay, jump scare. Where the face and hands of Henry Wentworth Eagley. Okay. I'm sorry. Okay, das war's. Ja, das war's. Okay. Cool. Das war's. Kapitel 8 war tatsächlich das letzte Kapitel. Und sehr Lovecraftig. Wunderbar. Dann würde ich sagen, beim nächsten Mal probieren wir irgendein anderes auf H.P. Lovecrafts basierenden Spielen aus für diese Reihe. Ich habe noch ein paar auf der Festplatte, die ich selber irgendwie noch nicht wirklich ausprobiert habe. Das kann man dann machen. So Cthulhu Saves the World habe ich da und noch so ein paar andere. Ich glaube Euclidean oder so gibt es eins. Und noch irgendein anderes. Aber das sehen wir dann. Bis zum nächsten Mal.